Heart's Channel here again for our 40 days and 40 minutes with Jesus. This is day 3 in the morning, and I want to thank you all for sharing. I see a lot of shares happening. I see the numbers on the videos going up, and I just want to remind you that this is a time for courage. This is a time for authenticity. I have been listening to an interview on YouTube this morning with 4 wonderful gentlemen. I'll put the link in the video to the video below, and really just inspiring conversation that now is the time for us to be 100% behind what we believe in. This is the reclamation of our sovereignty right now, and there are times I'm not as brave as I should be, although some of you may think I'm extremely brave. I notice that on my personal Facebook page, I often don't share my channeling because it's radical and there are people on there that it might annoy. Now, that could be surprising to some of you, but that I realized in Jesus's challenge to share these channelings, that everyone who's on my personal page who is a follower is sharing, and I too am sharing. So even though I do this in public and thousands of people see what I'm channeling, I still have that little bit in me that doesn't want to upset people in my personal circle. So today I give up that fear, and choose to be courageous. Sorry. Just give me a sec here. Let's see what Jesus has to say to us today. You are blessed beings indeed. I am that one that you know as Jesus. You all have things to learn. This being is showing you her vulnerability. This being is showing you that she's the same as you. All she has done is practice something that has transformed her life enough to override your society's fearful indoctrinations. And yet there are still dregs of that alive in her, and she sees that and she feels that. And for those of you that are moved by this, be brave. Share these videos. Show those you love who you truly are. For if they love you truly, they will have to come to terms with your beliefs and ideas. And the truth of the matter is that your programming in your society has shepherded you into corrals where you are afraid. You are literally afraid to be yourselves. And this is the weakness, this is the disconnection from your sovereignty that has allowed this debacle to happen on earth, and you all need to own your part of it. Where have you been complicit in hiding your belief in freedom, in hiding your belief in truth, in hiding your authenticity, who you truly are, what you value and what you want for humanity? This is the time for all of this to be revealed. 2020 vision. It is no coincidence that this year is 2020. There are symbols throughout eternity that give you clues as to what is happening. Clear vision means that you see yourself clearly. Clear vision means that you see what is happening clearly. And clear vision means that you come to understand the remedy for deception and secrecy. The remedy for deception and secrecy and manipulation is truth, clarity, and authenticity. And this is what you are being asked to rise up into in these 40 days and 40 nights. Many of you have secrets that you hide on a daily basis, insecurities and fears about what you think about yourself, projecting it onto other people, believing it is they that think that. And it is not. It is you that thinks that. And you become scared of your own mind. A Course in Miracles will teach you to love your own mind, and it will give you the courage over the years to reveal to yourself exactly what you do, what you are, what you value, and what you fear. It is a most amazing course because you do not have to believe in it to have it work on you. You do not have to believe in it. You do not have to like it. All you have to do is do it. And what that does is releases your free will into the realm of faith. Now, many of you have lost faith in the word faith, but every single one of you has faith in something. You may have faith in hiding your true nature. You may have faith in money. You may have faith in bodies. You may have faith in your family. But the truth of the matter is you need to have faith in life. And this is what is being undermined at this time in your world, this faith in life, as if you are all likely to die in the next minute or so if you do not conform, constrict, and restrain yourselves away from that which you are. You are ideas in the mind of God. You are freedom-seeking beings. You are creative beings. You are loving beings. And you are being corralled into the very opposite: separation, isolation, fear of each other, increased separation. But you can only have this done to you if you agree to it. You can only have this done to you if you agree to it. But the journey is an internal one. It is difficult to change deeply indoctrinated behavior unless you change the beliefs you hold in your mind about your value, about reality, about what life is, about what love is. You must change your mind first before you can change your behavior. You can force change your behavior. And this is what some people do, for example, if they are on a weight loss program or a fitness program. They will force themselves to go to the gym. They will force themselves to stop eating the foods that are making them overweight. But they cannot keep it up because the behavior of laziness and overeating are arising from within the most powerful thing on the planet, which is the human mind and the belief in its beliefs. If you believe that being overweight will keep you safe, if you truly believe that in your mind, you will not be able to become slim. If you believe that becoming fit is going to endanger you somehow or make you stand out in a way that is uncomfortable, you will not keep it up. It is not the fitness or the eating that is the issue. It is the mind underlying them that is the issue. And in this case, with what's happening on your planet right now, it is your individual minds that are contributing to the loss of freedom. It is your individual minds that are contributing to the compliance. It is your individual minds that are leading you towards a prison. So each one of you must take responsibility for what you believe to be true about the world, about your body, about life, about death, about love, about each other. And the course will set you straight on those subjects. So once again, if you have not done A Course in Miracles, we would suggest that you begin to read this being's books, because the ideas about the course, the introduction to some of the concepts, are deeply investigated in those books in a language and in a manner that is easily consumable. And once you have read those books, and those books are brought to this planet at this time for this time, we knew that we had to bring material through that was going to assist humanity in handling what was coming down the pipe. And that is why this being was so dedicated to writing and publishing these books, not through any foreknowledge of her own, but through an overwhelming urge that was coming from us to get this material out to as many people as possible. So if you have hesitated to purchase this book, perhaps because of the title, perhaps because of finances, we urge you now, because the information you need is in there. The information you need to understand your own mind is in there. And it will, if you are reluctant to do A Course in Miracles, give you enough information to caress you and urge you towards that final destination of owning the fact that your mind is the problem. We are not saying you are bad. What we are saying is that your mind has been usurped by a system that understands the power of thought and the power of creativity. Why do you think that creativity is not encouraged in school? Why do you think psychology and psychotherapy is not taught to you in school so that you understand your emotions, you understand your feelings? The system does not want you to. You must now reparent yourself and re-educate yourself and come to understand how your mind works and how it has been manipulated. We seek freedom, joy, and happiness for every single one of you. But it cannot come from a government. It cannot come from a source outside of yourself. It must arise from within your own divinity. It must arise from within your own heart and mind. And it does every single day. And that is the shame of it. You all have impeccable guidance. You know the second you don't want to do something. You know the second that something doesn't feel right. And yet your conditioned minds override you time and time again, leading you down a path of unhappiness, restriction, and limitation. Now is the time for you to choose freedom. And yes, the lessons of A Course in Miracles seem to be the opposite. You have to do this and you have to do that. But what you are doing is taking back the reins of this magnificent, powerful, creative device that you own, free and clear. Your mind, your heart, your soul. Now is a time to reclaim your mind, your heart, and your soul, knowing that it is the greatest contribution that you can make to humanity at this time. I am that one you know as Jesus, and I will speak to you again later today. Thank you all for joining me this morning. I'll see you later today. Bye-bye.